हेलो हेलो wants to say that we can go for a life and I can start the session.
We are already live.
Okay. A very good morning to one and all present here. On behalf of Soundarya Institute of Management and Science and NPTEL, the extension of IIT Madras. So we are having a live session today on NPTEL awareness program. On this occasion, I would take a privilege to welcome our CEO, Mr. Kirtan Kumar and his absentia. I would like to welcome our principal, Dr. Vasu sir, for this session. And the key resource person, Mr. Shiv Shankar Das, for the session. And all the faculty fraternity who have joined this session and my student friends. So before we start, there is a small quick cue that I would like to give why we are having this NPTEL. And nowadays, why this NPTEL program has become, one of the most promising program and one of the most important program which upskills the knowledge of the students in various domain. As we all know that this YM program is initiated by Government of India, and it is designed to achieve the three principles of education policy via access, equality, and quality. The objective of this effort is to take the best of all the learning resources, including both bridging and digital divide. Keeping that in mind, this NPTEL has the four quadrants, that is, having a video lecture, having a special prepared readiness material, the downloaded material, the quizzes, the assessment, and so on. There are a lot of agencies or a lot of the educational partners who are helping them in doing this program very effectively. One being an AICT, NPTEL, UGC, CEC, NCERT, NIOS, IIMB, NITTR. So all these knowledge partners are helping not only in the age group of the students from 10 to 50, but it is a student group of 10 to 70 to 80 age people are registering for NPTEL. So it's a great privilege for students and an opportunity for the students to come up in such a way that not only with their regular curriculum, if they with the courses which is well structured and well designed by the team, it will definitely help students to pursue their career in a great height. So having that in mind, we, the Soundarya Institute of Management and Science, are very happy to associate with NPTEL in the year 2019, and hence we are continuing since 4 years. So further about the course and other things, I would be very happy to introduce my principal, who will be giving you a glimpse about the institution of Soundarya and why and how we started the NPTEL program. So it would be a great opportunity for all of us. So let's connect and understand what is an NPTEL program through the principal sir as well as to the resource person of the day. Thank you, sir. Over to you.
Very good morning to all the dignitaries, students. Soundarya Institute of Management was established in the year 2007. And since then, since Soundarya Institute of Management, Sciences and Management has been striving towards attaining quality education. That was the vision of our chairman, Sri Soundarya P. Manjappa, and also been ably supported by our CEO, Sri Kirtan Kumar sir. This program of NTPL has been very seriously taken by our department in or by all the departments, especially under the steward leadership of Rekha ma'am and her team. We were able to establish the Swayam NTPL local chapter 2910 in the year 2019. Since then, 300 plus students have taken part in the Swayam NTPL program. Every year, about 45 to 60% of the students complete the certification program, out of which many have completed the program with elite, silver, and silver medal. Along with the students, faculty have also actively taken part. We are between the 78th and 84th position pan-India since 2019. So all the credit goes to our faculty members and students who have taken these programs seriously. As per the UGC norms, Swayam has been very nicely implemented and taken care by all our departments. I wish all the best to our students to understand the concept of NTPL and its various programs offered, and they can take the advantage of it. Apart from their regular degree, these certifications will add value for their skill as well as for their employment. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Now I request our resource person of the day, Shiv Shankar Das, to take over the session.
Good morning to Principal Sir, SPOC Madam, the faculty members and the students who are connected to this program to YouTube session. During this, this is the program which has been organized in consultation with Soundarya Institute. Let me share my screen and then we move forward. Just. Okay, this Swayam NPTEL Awareness Workshop is being organized in association with Soundarya Institute of Management and Science, Bangalore. During this 1 hour talk, actually 1 hour is too less if you really want to talk about the NPTEL and different initiatives taken by you. So what we'll do, we'll just take whatever the minimum time is required to just hurriedly go through all the programs, and also I'll be looking at the YouTube channel chat boxes. Whenever the questions are coming, we'll be taking parallelly the questions as we progress. Okay. Now, during this talk, we'll be talking about the NPTEL and Swayam online certification program, credit transfer mechanism, how the domain certification can be obtained, internship opportunities for the course toppers, the soft skill training that NPTEL imparts for the benefit of the learners. GATE portal is a very useful portal for particularly for the students who are aspiring to write GATE examination, the faculty development program, and other initiatives taken by NPTEL that we'll talk about. Then NPTEL local chapter and NPTEL self-paced courses. These are the brief outline of the talk. The NPTEL, which started in 2003, with an aim to provide a high quality, affordable education to the learners, was initiated by 7 older IITs and ISC Bangalore with financial support from the Ministry of HRD, the then Ministry of HRD, and now renamed as Ministry of Education, Government of India. During the first phase, that is 2003 to 2013, we have been primarily focusing on creating contents which will be made available in just video format, or there are some courses in the wave format. That is, there are PDF type of booklets that were created for a particular course. So during 2003 to 2014, or early 2013, we just concentrated on developing or recording the contents created by, you can say, faculty delivering the lectures in the classrooms of IITs and making it available for the outside learners. That's how we moved. But from 2014, the course level certification program was initiated. How it happened actually? Now, during this period, earlier, only thing I could go through the course contents, which is from NPTEL, and learn it ourselves. But I will not have any option to show it to the outside world that, okay, see, I have learned this course from IITs, and this is my certificate, which clearly shows the level of my understanding on that particular subject. So from 2014, aligning with the global trend when online certification programs were coming in a big way, we also changed our strategy and started offering course level certification. During 2003 to 2023, during this 20 years tenure, we have actually provided or created more than 3,000 unique courses. Okay. These unique courses are available through the YouTube channel of NPTEL, that is NPTEL HRD, as well as you can see the number of subscription in the YouTube, that is 4.5 million plus YouTube subscriptions are available right now. As well as if you see the viewership is more than 1.6 billion. How much contents we have created? It's not only 3,000 lectures or the course contents, which is almost equivalent to more than 62,000 hours of lectures. Many of these contents are available with English subtitles also. So from 2014, we are not only offering the courses for certification purpose, but we are also organizing such workshops, which is being organized today, so that these contents are being utilized by the universities and autonomous colleges for the credit transfer. Okay. Now, once we say that we are offering the courses in under the NPTEL, that is IITs and ISCs are offering the courses under the NPTEL program, there should be a platform to which we should be offering. Now, the Rekha Ma'am was already describing like different, say, national coordinators who are offering the courses spanning the school children to the higher education sector, that is high-end researchers. So similarly, here we have got 19 national coordinators who are targeting for the school children, out-of-school children, undergraduate and postgraduate studies. So there is some agency which is targeting a particular segment of learners. Okay, now NPTEL is the national coordinator for primarily for offering the courses from undergraduate and postgraduate engineering sector. But since each of the IITs, they have basic science, humanities, and social sciences management disciplines, we do offer courses from all these disciplines also. Which started at only 7 IITs and ISC Bangalore, 8 institutes. Now we have spanned our horizon and we have incorporated many other institutions, the newer IITs, triple IITs, other reputed universities, they are under this fold and they are also offering the courses, not only within this ambit, but we are also offering the courses from health sector, as well as different laws courses are also offered. Say, once you say that, okay, we are offering the online certification and it started in 2014, which is the format, how do we offer? We offer the courses in the MOOCs format, that is massive open online courses, which clearly says how the actually delivery takes place. The massive means, that means the number of students who can enroll in a course is not limited by the brick and mortar classroom. Okay, since it is an open online course, that means the contents are delivered in an online mode through internet. And anyone who is having an interest and internet connectivity should be able to access these contents. That means the number of students is not limited. You can have hundreds or hundreds of thousands of students enrolling in a particular course. Now the courses, they are no way different from your regular classroom-based courses. That means it has a fixed syllabus, it has a start date, end date. Every week, a certain amount of contents or videos are released. There are other activities that we talk about in the four-quadrant approach, That means what all activities that takes place in a regular university system, all the features of the regular university classroom features are available in the MOOCs format also. And the model is AAA. That means anyone can take this course, do it at their convenient time, that is anytime and from anywhere. So irrespective of what a person is doing currently, age, gender, anyone should be able to access these contents which are available in the MOOCs format to NPTEL. We follow the four quadrant approach. Possibly in the next slide it will be clear what are these four quadrants. Courses, once we say that we are offering the online courses, what should be the timeline? We are offering the courses twice in a year, aligning with the university system. That is, either the courses are started in January or in July. The January run courses are offered primarily between January to April, and the July run courses are offered from July and ends in October. All NPTEL courses are offered to the SWAYAM, so they are also called SWAYAM courses. We'll also see which are the courses that are forthcoming from July. Now the courses have already started from yesterday, 24th onwards, and it will be continuing. The enrollment process for these the courses which have started on 24th July will close on 31st of July. That timelines we'll see, and what are the courses that also we'll see in that coming slides. So the enrollment for the January and July courses starts in November and May respectively. That means for the January run courses, by mid of November, the enrollment process starts, and for the July run courses, by mid of May, the enrollment process will be open. As we said, that it follows a AAA model, that means enrollment in any course is possible irrespective of any branch of study. That means if I am studying, say, in mining engineering, I should be able to join a course from computer science, electrical, electronics, civil engineering, psychology, economics, management, mathematics, whatever it is. Whatever subject interests me, I should be able to take that course irrespective of what we are studying currently. This is primarily for the currently who are in the academic calendar, that is students. It can be, say, the learners, if they are interested, they can join in multiple number of courses. It's not only one course, they can, if they want, they can join in 6, 8, 10 courses for learning. And the important part is that these courses are absolutely free. They can join to the course for learning purpose without paying any fee. Okay, they are absolutely funded by the Ministry of Education, so no payment is to be made. Enrollment for joining or joining into the course for learning purpose is absolutely free. But if someone is interested to get a certificate after completing the course, in that case, a separate registration takes place to NPTEL. And the certification exam is to be appeared by paying certain fees. Now the course features, we talked about four quadrant approach that we'll talk about in this slide. What are the course duration? We know in a semester system also, you have 3 months or 4 months duration, and that is in terms of the hours also, a certain number of hours is to be completed for a particular course. Now here also we have got in terms of weeks or in terms of hours, different variation. If we say that, okay, we have got 3 variation of courses, that is a full semester course is called 30 hours. We have got medium type of courses of 20 hours, and on a top fixed topic, specialized topic, the courses are offered of 10 hours duration. In terms of weeks or duration, you can say these are equivalent to 12 weeks, 8 weeks, or 4 weeks respectively. That means a 30-week hours course will be completed within a period of 12 weeks time at the rate of 2.5 hours of lecture per week. That means we are offering you 2.5 hours of lecture. They are not a single lecture of 2.5 hours, but they are multiple lectures. The maximum duration we expect that, okay, we'll be giving roughly 30 minutes of lecture in a single module. Okay, so in that case, there could be 5 or 6 small videos of half an hour or 20 minutes duration comprising a week's content. So once we say that there are 4 quadrants, which are the four quadrants? As we said, the 2.5 hours of lecture are being made available. These are pre-recorded lectures, the small video lectures of 2.5 hours. They are made available as first quadrant. Now in a classroom, in addition to the lecture delivery, the faculty will be interacting with the students, whether they have understood correctly or not, or the students will be asking the question to the teacher. So there is a face-to-face interaction takes place on a question-answer session. Since it is an online course, the students are scattered geographically, so that feature is naturally not available. So the interaction takes place through a web-based interactive forum. Okay, so where the students, after going through the video, they'll be posting their queries, and these queries will be answered in a time-bound manner by the faculty and the teaching assistants associated with the course. Mr. Shashidhar, you have asked, could you please tell us how to apply for internship in NPTEL? Yes, sir. I will be discussing more on this once we come to the internship slide. Please kindly wait for it. Okay. So the second quadrant is definitely interaction. Now we say that interaction takes place through the web-based forum. Now see, in addition to that, what we try to give a flavor of classroom facing thing. Like as someone named Pasula Sridhar asked a question about the internship opportunity, we took the question and answered. So similarly, what we do, we ask the faculty to come on a YouTube live session like what we are doing today. And in the session, the students will be posting their queries in the forum, which will be picked up by the students and will be answered immediately. That's how we try to provide some flavor of face-to-face interaction. Additionally, we are also engaging the PMRF scholars, Prime Minister's Research Fellow Scholars, for providing support to the students. For this, the problem-solving sessions are periodically conducted by the PMRF scholars. So in the faculty will be primarily discussing about the theoretical concepts in the lecture. What about the problems? They will be coming in the assignment, weekly assignment. So now there should be some guidance to the students on how to solve the problem. Since if the faculty doesn't have much time to give much details in how to solve the problems, there are PMRF scholars who will be supporting this program all along the program duration. Every week they'll be conducting problem solving session where they will say how to solve similar problems. Okay. Then comes supplementary study materials. What are these? In addition to in a regular classroom also, the teacher may give handwritten notes and all. Same thing is made available here. Either the text transcript, that is whatever the faculty has said in a classroom, the same thing is converted into a text, and PDF version of the English text transcripts are made available. For certain courses, we are also providing the text transcript in different regional languages, be it Kannada, Tamil, Telugu, Malayalam, Bengali, Oriya, Hindi, whatever it is, we are trying to provide in regional languages. Additionally, if the faculty has used PowerPoint slides, we try to provide that slide so that it helps the learners in rapid revision purpose. As well as the faculty may also give certain handwritten notes for free web resources, if any. Additionally, after going through the videos, after going through the supplementary study materials and getting all my doubts clarified through web-based interactive forum, I'll be exposed to a self-assessment quiz every week. What is that? Every week, in addition to the videos, the course instructor will be releasing a set of questions related to that. That set of questions are called assignments, which is for self-assessment purpose. It can have 15 to 20 or 10 to 20 questions, each with certain weightage. The total weightage, if say 10, 15, 20 is equivalent to 100 marks. That means each assignment will be graded. That means once I complete the assignment and submit it, I should be able to see what is my score out of 100 in that particular assignment. And a part of this assignment score will be taken for the certification purpose. Okay. At this point, let me, just before I move forward to the next slide, let me take another question. There is a question from Mule Subham. Any help for gate exam from NPTEL? Let me tell you, sir, there's a great help you can actually take from NPTEL. We'll talk more about this internship and gate exam related support from NPTEL in the coming slide. Kindly bear with us and stay with us till we reach to that stage. Okay, thank you. So we talked about the course features. So these are the four quadrants. Now, once we complete, that means if I join in a 30-hour course, what I'll have? I'll have 12 weeks of video contents, each week 2.5 hours of lecture. After going through the video, I'll be asking the questions in the forum. I'll go through the supplementary study materials, then solve the assignments, 12 assignments, each of 100 marks. Okay, this is what every week I'll be continuing. For a 12 weeks course, this will be for eight weeks, this process will continue. Now, once the course is over, now I feel that, okay, I should be writing the exam. Since writing the exam, that means there should be some arrangement for examination process. There is a timeline during which I have to register. So if I have decided that I'll be writing the exam for this particular course, I have to register separately within the timeline. What are the features of this certification exam? For a course enrollment, and for learning purpose, I can actually learn it from the comfort of my home. But for the certification exam, the USP of NPTEL is that you have to come to the center. It is a center-based in-person proctored exam. Okay. So the student who is registering for the exam has to come to the center with a valid government-issued identity card and write the exam in the center. Where are the exam centers? The exam centers are spread across the country. At more than 200 cities, we conduct the examination. Okay. The exam usually, in most of the cases, is online, but for certain courses, it is offline. The fine difference between these two, online and offline, is that in an online exam, the question and the answer, everything takes place in the computer. That means we see the questions and we answer the questions also in the computer. But whereas for the offline exam, the questions definitely comes in the questions will be appearing in the computer, but definitely the answers for answering the offline papers, I will be given a conventional answer script where I have to rewrite using my pen paper. Okay, exams are conducted on 3 days in a semester, 2 sessions per day, that means maximum 6 exam sessions in a semester. That means if I want, I can write for 6 examinations for certifications in a semester. Many of the times you get a query that I have taken courses whose exams are clashing on the same day. If there are 2 courses whose exam dates are clashing, don't worry about that. Registered for the exam, and if you are registering for the exam using the same email ID, then in that case, you will be given in forum session 1 paper and in the afternoon session 2nd paper. And there are many students who are actually writing the exam for 6 courses in this manner. Examination, as we said, for learning purpose, if you enroll into the course, yes, there is no fee attached to that. But for the writing the examinations, it is proctored in-person exam, there are certain costs associated with, because NPTEL engages an exam partner who will be conducting the exam. So as per our norm, since 2014, we are taking 1,000 rupees per course, irrespective of the course duration. That is, whether it's a 4 weeks, 8 weeks, or 12 weeks, the fee structure remains same for general candidates. Why I'm saying general candidates? Because for the certain category of students like SC, ST, and persons with disability, having more than 40% disability, are permitted to have 50% fee waiver as per norms. Okay, for this, during examination registration, they have to provide their birth certificate or medical certificate claiming that, okay, what is the percentage of disability, and get the fee waiver. Once the exams are conducted, whether in online or offline, the results are published tentatively within 30 days from the exam. Okay, certificates what we issue, they are all e-verifiable soft copy of the certificate. Each certificate will be signed by the institute that is offering the course. If the certificate is, say, the course is offered by IIT Bombay, then the certificate will be signed by the IIT Bombay officials of NPTEL. Certificates with DRA QR code, so that anyone, if you produce that certificate to an agency, they should be able to verify the authenticity of the certificate simply by scanning the QR code. Before we go to the next slide, I'll take another question. Sir, are these certificates beneficial for to get a job? Yes, sir. These are absolutely beneficial. I think in the next slide, it will be much more clear why we are saying these are beneficial. Okay. Certification criteria. Now we say that during the entire duration of the course, and every week we are getting an assignment. And each assignment is graded out of 100. Okay. And then there is a final examination. Now in the certification, you have got certain weightage of final exam and certain weightage comes from the assignment. What is the distribution? We see there are certain courses which have been programming in nature, say C, C++, Java, Python, Verilog. In such courses, there will be three components. That is, some components will come from the final exam, some from the assignment, and some from a weightage will come from the non-proctored programming examination, which will be conducted before the exam on two sessions. On a particular date for these particular courses, C, C++, Java, Python, Verilog, such courses, a particular date will be given to the learners. During the day and during the night, there are two sessions when the students have to actually appear for a non-proctored programming test. What does it mean? That means the students will be able to take the exam either in their college, from their home, without anyone checking whether that same person is doing on the assignment or not. So that is non-programming. Okay. Now for non-programming courses, there are two components. 75% weightage of the final exam is taken for the certification and the remaining 25% comes from the assignment score, weekly assignment score. But for the programming courses, the final exam will carry only 50% weightage and the remaining 50% is split between non-proctored programming test and assignment. So 50, 25, 25, this is the distribution for programming courses. Now we say that in both the cases, we are saying that 25% weightage comes from the assignment. How do we calculate that? For a 12-week course, we will only consider the best 8 assignment scores. Each assignment is graded out of 100. That means if you have submitted all 12 assignments, we'll just say that, okay, which are the best 8 assignments scored in a 12-week course? Take an average of that. So out of 800, what is the score? Find out what is the score out of 100 and take directly 25% from there. Similarly, for the 8 weeks and 4 weeks, the best 6 or best 3 assignment scores are taken. Once we calculate the average score, 25% is directly taken for the certificate. Now say you consider a situation where you have taken a 8-week course and we are considering the best 6 assignment marks. You have only submitted 4 assignments. In that case, is it that, okay, you are not permitted to write the exam? We say no, that's not the case. There are certain other conditions that you have to meet, but see how we calculate the average assignment score and how it is linked to what is the minimum score that you have to obtain to get a certificate. Say you have submitted only 4 assignment scores. In that case, what we will see that, okay, 6 was the minimum requirement and you have submitted 4 only. So in the remaining 2 assignments, you have received 0 marks. That means 4 out of 400 marks will be considered as 4 out of 600 marks. So the average score out of 100 will come down and 25% also will be coming down. So we say that if you score at least 40% marks here, that means 10 marks out of 25 is available in the assignment, then you are eligible to get a certificate. Okay, provided you get 40% marks in the final exam also, that means 30 out of 75. Okay, we have got 5-point grading. That means if the cumulative total is less than 40, we say the candidate is unsuccessful. We don't provide any certificate, not even a participation certificate. Scores between 40 to 59, we say you have completed the course successfully. 60 onwards, 60 to 100, we provide a, you can say, allied word on the top of the certificate. This indicates the score is between 60 to 100. For 60 to 74, this only particular, this allied word will be written. Whereas between 75 to 89, in addition to allied word, you'll be having a silver, you can say, badge symbol. Okay. For 75 to 89, score. This will be elite silver. For 90 to 100, it will be elite gold. Gold medal symbol will be printed onto the certificate. Additionally, if your score is within top 1% or 2% or 5% of the scorers, you'll be having a topper seal also printed onto the certificate. Okay. How does the sample certificate looks like? This is how it look like. Elite word is there, that means the score is between 60 to 100. The candidate's name, photograph, the course name, the distribution of assignment marks out of 25, proctored exam out of 75. Here you should get at least 10, here you should get at least 30 individually to get a certificate. If you get, say, here 20 out of 25, but here if you get, say, less than 30, you don't get a certificate. Similarly, if you get 75 out of 75 here, but if you do not get 10 here out of 25, you don't get a certificate. Then how many people wrote the exam and how many people actually certified? Here is written the course when it was offered, which institute offered the course, your roll number, QR code, all these informations are available, and the certificate will bear the logo of NPTEL and SWAM, indicating this is SWAM. Important points to remember is that NPTEL will be identifying the learners by your unique email ID. We don't say identify you by your name, because if you see there are 30, say 25 lakhs, 30 lakh students enrolling into the courses. So there could be many people by the same name. So we'll be just going by the unique email ID. So during the runtime of the course, if you change your email ID, then all data related to that previous email ID is lost. So you should always, once you have joined into the course, continue with the same email ID. Check exam dates beforehand, before enrolling into the course, if you want to go for the certification exam. You should not choose a courses which has got same exam date. That means more than two courses should not be chosen which will has got same exam date. Same email ID is to be used for course enrollment and exam registration. Since these certificates are to be produced for the credit transfer or for the prospective employers for job, say internship or job opportunities, so you should always upload a formal passport photograph during the exam registration. This is important. Many of the courses will require the assistance of uses of calculators, but kindly note that physical calculators are not permitted to be used in the examination. And you have to use the TCS approved online on-screen calculators. You can just Google search that TCS Iron online on-screen calculators. I have just reproduced the link here. It will take you to the calculator page and you can see this is available. So try to make best use of these during the entire assignment stage so that you are thoroughly conversant with how to use the on-screen calculator. Okay, if your college is planning to take, say, multiple number of students who will be writing the exam, it's good that if you actually inform NPTEL beforehand that okay, how many people are going to write the exam. This is just to help the, say, NPTEL in planning the logistics for the examination. Timelines. Now, we are saying that we are opening the courses from January to July, January and July starting. Now, we have got three variation of courses, 4 weeks, 18th and 12th. Now, we understand that okay, many of the universities will be starting their semester in the early phase of July. Someone will be starting a little later. So, just to help the people, those who are starting their semester a little late, we are segregating the courses, 4 weeks and 8 weeks courses, in two sets. The first set of 4 weeks, first set of 8 weeks, and all 12 weeks courses will start from 24th, or rather started from 24th of July, yesterday onwards. It has started. The enrollment process for all these courses will end by 31st of July by 5 p.m. Okay. Now, the second set of 4 weeks and second set of 8 weeks will start exactly 1 month later, on 21st of August, and the enrollment will close on the same day. Now, course are started. Every week, your video lectures, supplementary study material, assignments, they are available. Now, the 4 weeks course will be completed within a month's time. This will be completed within 2 months' time. So, the first four set of 4 weeks and 8 weeks, we'll have an examination on 24th of September on two sessions. Morning between 9 to 12 and afternoon between 2 to 5. Okay. So, if I take two courses from this group, I should be able to write two courses here. Now comes your three courses, that is 12 weeks, 4 weeks, and 8 weeks. They will be having a combined exam on October 28th and 29th. Again, two sessions per day. That means here four sessions, here two sessions. If someone wishes to write maximum examinations for certification purpose, then how many courses they can actually take? Two in the 24th September and 4 during October 28th and 29th. That means 6 exams can be written. Okay. Now, exam has, you have got a fixed date when you can actually write the examination or register for the examination. The timelines are given as August 14 is the timeline for enrolling into the first set of 4 weeks, first set of 8 weeks, and all 12 weeks courses. The second set of 4 weeks and 8 weeks, the last date is 11th of September. That is without paying any late fee. However, if you are compelled to take the late fee process, then 18th August and 15th September is the timeline where you have to pay extra charges and complete the exam registration. So if you have already decided to enroll into the course and be going for the certification, do not delay it further. Registered so that NPTEL knows how many people will be writing and is in a position to provide necessary logistic equipment and ensure that you get an exam center closer to your place or of your choice. Now we have seen the NPTEL activities. What are the things now? Okay, I want to take a course. What are the steps that I should follow periodically? I have known that, okay, these are the activities that takes place during the NPTEL offering stage. First, I have to check the timeline and course list. Where do I go? I'll go to nptel.ac.in portal. Here, if you just go to nptel.ac.in, just if you scroll down, you'll find there are NPTEL list of courses and timelines and guidelines. If timelines and guidelines, what I have shown you here is taken from this point only. Okay. The previous slide, what I have shown. But if you click onto the list of courses, you'll find here you have got an Excel sheet that gives complete details of what all courses we are offering. We are offering about 690 courses during July to October, and all 690 courses are listed here. You have got the discipline, name of the course, the faculty who is offering the course, then which institute is offering. The duration of the course, 4 weeks, 8 weeks, 12 weeks, and some, see here, this particular column tells you whether it's a redone or new. What is the difference between these two? New means this course has been created now and is being offered for the first time. The redone means this course was created earlier and this is being offered, say, earlier also it was offered, is now being offered additional time. Maybe N plus one times it is being offered. So, for a redone course, you have got all the videos already available in the portal, as well as some other, say, information is available. The details I'll show in the next slide. Okay. So, new courses, as and when the courses are, say, every week basis, the videos, assignments, all these things will be available. But for the redone courses, the videos are already available in the portal. So, if you are taking a redone course, you can already see the contents before they are made available in the live portal. What is the course start date? Course end date, exam registration date, whether the course is of undergraduate level, postgraduate level, whether it's a core course, elective course, whether the courses are marked for the faculty development program, whether these are aligned with any of the faculty, your domains, that we'll talk a little later. Domains, you can see here, flight mechanics. We'll just show you what is this flight mechanics domain later. Okay. And whether this course's joining link is given. So all this information in a single sheet is available from nptel.ac.in portal. Okay. So I have seen what are the courses available. If I want to see, okay, what are the courses that are forthcoming from January 2024, next semester, that also I'll be able to see beforehand. Where do I go? I'll go to, you can just search it, say NPTEL semester information. In that case, it will give you, say, Jan 2024, you can see the timeline here. You'll be able to see when the course from the January session will be available, as well as you'll be able to see what are the tentative course list for the January to April 2024. Here also, this list is not final, but as and when we add more courses, this will be reflected here. Okay, so we have not only seen, but do I see the current set of courses, that is that which is forthcoming, as well as in the next semester, what all courses are coming, along with the timelines is available. Now I have decided, okay, I'll be taking either a new course or rerun course. If I choose to take a rerun course, what are the things I can see in the portal? Since it was offered earlier, what are the things available? I'll go to nptel.ac.in portal and see here I can search the courses by name. Okay, let me search a course, say Python. Say the joy of computing using Python. Say this is the course which is being offered this semester, but this was also available earlier. Okay, so another things you can just note, this is self-paced certificate. This will take discuss more about it once we go for NPTEL Plus program, self-paced certification. What is this? Okay, now what is this available? You can see here. I'll be able to see all the course contents here on a weekly basis. Additionally, what other things are available here? Under the download section, I'll be getting multiple assignment. That means in the last semester, one of the last semester, the type of assignments, weekly assignments, which was given to the students for solving is reproduced here. Kindly keep in mind that the same assignment will not be provided this time. But this will give you some idea like what type of assignment questions are asked in a weekly basis. Sorry. So here you'll be able to see. See, I can, if I just click onto the download link, I should be able to see a particular assignment, how it was given. Okay. Additionally, what I see here, in a rerun course, I should be able to see the text translate. Say I am done this course, I am doing this course. On a particular topic, if I want to see, okay, the faculty has taught, and if I can get the English text transcript, I can download it from here. I can also download the Hindi, Kannada, Malayalam, all these text transcript. This will be helpful for the learners, particularly those who have studied in, say, Kannada medium, and they are not very conversant in, say, English lectures being delivered in a classroom. To help the students initially, the students can take the help of Kannada transcripts which is available and slowly pick up that. Okay, so this is just to help the student. I can also download the whole transcript in a booklet format. So if I want to download in a Kannada format, I should be able to download the complete booklet in Kannada format, what is joy of computing using Python course. Okay. This is the ability. So this way it helps the learners. Now, after going through this, if I want to enroll into the course, first I have seen what are the courses, what are the next semester courses. If it is a redone course, what are the things available in the portal already? Then I go to the swayam.gov.in portal for enrolling in a particular course. Okay, If I do not know the names also, I have already selected the course, I can type the course name here and directly go to the course page. Else, I can also click onto the all courses here. It will display all courses which are currently available for enrollment in the SWAYAM portal. Okay. Here, you can see the courses from NPTEL, CEC, EGC. But if I am interested only for the NPTEL course, I'll put the appropriate filter here. National coordinator, I choose NPTEL. Then all NPTEL courses will be shown here. Then I can also select, okay, whether I want a 4-week course, 8-week course, or 12-week course. Okay, let me select the 12-week course from NPTEL. And also I want to filter it out like, okay, I want to take, say, a course from NPTEL domain. Which domain? Say, you are seeing something, say, foundation of computing or flight mechanics. This domain I want to take. No, there is no course at this point. Oh, this is the courses which are from this domain. Now say, I want to enroll into this course. What I do? This is the course card where it is shown the discrete mathematics course by these faculties. NPTEL is offering the course. This is the duration, timelines, all this available. I click onto the course card. It will take me to the next course enrollment page. Here, I'll get further details about the course. A small video where the faculty has said, what is the learning outcome of this course? About the course, who are the intended audience? Anyone who is interested in the course, they should be able to join. Industry support means which are the industries that would appreciate this particular course knowledge. The course syllabus, faculty biography, certification process, all these things are available. Now, if I want to enroll into the course, what I do? I know that there are 3,000 people I have already enrolled in the course. If I want to be 3,027th number, I just click on the join button. There are a number of ways. I'll choose to go by my Google account because I'll be carrying this my Gmail ID all along my life as long as I want to carry forward. So if I want to use my Gmail account, so I'll be writing it has now taken me to the course enrollment page. Now here I see there are certain basic data it has taken. Now which age group I have to select? 50 to 60. Gender I have to select from the drop down. Country I have to select. Then if I select my PIN code, it will automatically take the state and my district or city. Then I have to select what is my profession, whether I am student, faculty, employed or other. If I am a student or faculty, that means I am connected with an academic institution. If I am employed, I am connected with some industry that may or may not be attached to NPTEL. Okay, what are these things you will do? Student and faculty, if you are connected with the college, that means the college could possibly be an NPTEL local chapter. And if the faculty is connected with an NPTEL industry associate program, that particular industry, we'll talk about that, they have to select that one. So if you are a student, select student, select from your this one, what is your highest qualification? Say if you are, say, in the high school or maybe 4 years bachelor's program or 3 years bachelor's degree, what is your year of graduation? Right now, say you are in the first year of your studies, you will be, say, graduating in 2026. That's also fine. Academic rank of grade, that is, if you are taking the courses from multiple national coordinators under SWAYAM, you'll be needing to generate a ABC ID, Academic Bank of Credits. But as far as the NPTEL is concerned, we'll not be looking at this. We'll be just looking at your NPTEL email ID. Okay. Then comes your, are you a local, from a local chapter? If it is from your local chapter, select yes. Select the local chapter state. So in this case, say if you are from Karnataka, select Karnataka. then select from here if I am Soundarya Institute of Management and Science, I select this institute. Then college roll number, degree that I am pursuing, say I am pursuing commerce and management department, it can be accounting and finance, I could be studying in the first year. Then you select, I agree to the SWAM terms and service and I agree to follow the honor code. Then click on to the join course. Okay. Now here I have already joined into the course. It is telling that thank you for registering in the course. Now since this course has already started, so we have already in week one contents are available. Week one, what all things we have? You have got a video. Different lecture videos are available here. You can see the videos from here. Additionally, what is available? See, these are all small videos. We say that we are giving 30 minutes or less. See, it's 1 minute video. The very small segment videos that the faculty has chosen to provide. Additionally, what you have got? You have got text transcript. You have got text transcript of that. English text transcript is available. You can download the videos, the live sessions that will talk little later. English book is also available. So all these things are available. Now, week one, we'll also see quiz. That is the week one assignment. You have got, after going through the videos and all other things, you have to submit the solution of this in the computer itself. See, each has got 1 point. How many questions are there? There are 10 points. That means 10 points means that each question is of equivalent to 10 marks. Okay, 10 points is equivalent to 100 marks. That means it is 10 marks each question. Within this 10 days time, that is, they have got 10 days time from Monday morning till next week's Wednesday, 11:59 is the timeline. You can see here timeline, date is given, 23:59 is the timeline when you have to submit the assignment. After this, you should be able to see your assignment score under the progress tab. Here you'll be able to see in out of 100 in the assignment one, what is your score. Okay, now say, after going through the video, you have got certain doubts. You want to ask a question to the faculty. Where do you go? You click onto the ask a question button. Here, see, many people have started asking the question here. So you'll be able to post your queries here, which will be answered by the faculty. As well as if you know as a peer group, peer learner, you are also permitted to answer the queries. And if your answer is wrong, the faculty will be correcting you. So this is a very good platform where you'll be actually interacting with the peer learners from different parts of the country. So here you have got all four quadrants. That is the first video. You have got forum for interaction. You have got assignment. You have got supplementary study materials. All these four quadrants are available here. Okay. Then if your college has actually provided a faculty who will be helping you as a first level of escalation point in your college, in your learning process, then the faculty will be acting as a mentor. If the faculty has enrolled into the course and the single point of contact from your college has identified that faculty as a mentor, then that mentor name should be available under this tab. And you'll be able to choose that particular faculty as your mentor. Okay. So these all facilities are available in the course page where every time you have to go. This announcement, whatever we do, that means once the course, say, videos are released, assignments are released, all these assignment solutions are released, all these informations are put into the announcement page. This will be available in the announcement tab as well as this will be sent to you in your regular registered email box also. Okay. Now we have seen all the things under SWAM, what, how to enroll into the course and how to complete the course. At the end, you will be writing the exam and for that, you have to go to examform.nptel.ac.in where you will be registering separately for the examination by paying 1,000 rupees or 500 rupees fee as the case may be. 500 is only for SC, ST and PWD candidates. So from this port, you'll be paying the fee and selecting, giving your option like what is your choice of city. Clear? I'm not getting any question from the forum. I do not know whether I am making your points clear or not. If you are understanding, you can just indicate me on the, you can say Google chat, YouTube chat box also. Now we have seen the NPTEL activities. We'll just see some of the statistics, because many of the time the students may feel that, okay, the courses are coming from IITs. It must be very tough. Should I actually attempt to that? So these statistics will give you some idea like what all things takes place here. Say if you are taking a course, say I was talking about a Python course. How do you check the Python course statistics? Say joy of computing using Python. Where do I see the statistics? We have seen the downloads tab. Under these statistics that I should be able to see when this course was offered previously, and how many people enrolled, how many people registered for the exam, and what was the percentage of people who successfully completed the courses. That means out of 4,666 courses, 4,045 people actually completed the course. That's a good number. That means I should be able to complete the course. Yes, there are certain courses which are considered tougher, which are math-based, math-intensive. So this data will possibly give you some idea whether you'll be able to cope up with the course pressure or not. Additionally, this subsequent few slides will give you some idea how many people registered, how many people write the exam, and what is the pass percentage. So far, for certification from this 2014 to 2023, we have created number of courses, but many of the courses have been offered multiple times in rerun mode. That is, so far, although we created 3,000 plus unique courses, we have offered about 5,372 courses, including new and redone courses. More than 2.3 crore plus learners enrolled into the courses. 28.6 lakhs plus learners registered for the examination. And out of that, we can see a large number of students or learners actually got a certificate. 18.8 lakhs people have been certified. What was the journey? What started as, say, during this thing, we have started with three courses in 2014 with 1 lakh students enrollment and about 3,000 students registering. Now, if you just see our graph, during the last year, we offered about, say, 1,213 courses, and you can see more than 40 lakhs people enrolling and 7.5 lakh people registering for the exam. In the last semester alone, we offered 665 courses, which has drawn 24 lakh plus students enrolling for the course and more than 5 lakh people registering for the examination. Okay, now here this semester, July to December semester, we are offering about 690 courses whose enrollment has not closed yet. It will continue till 31st of July. Okay. Now, we are not offering only the courses which are very popular, which will draw maybe maximum number of students, because these are not for commercial purpose. This is targeted to help or the benefit the learners from different segments. Okay, so we are not offering the courses only from, you can say, select discipline, but you can see the list. Not only you are offering the courses from the core engineering branches, but we are also the courses you can find from the physics, chemistry, mathematics, design, even not so popular engineering disciplines where it's not available elsewhere. Yeah, you can say across all engineering colleges like textile engineering, ocean engineering, maybe you can say, think about the mining engineering. These are also available in select group of institutions. We are offering those courses also, including agriculture and food engineering. We are offering courses from health science, law courses. Okay. So the number of courses that you see from the mechanical, computer science, electrical is almost comparable with the number of courses that comes from humanities management disciplines too. The exam attendance percentage, we see that, okay, how many people are registering for the exam and how many of them actually turn up for writing the exam? We find that more than 90%, almost 90% people turn up for the examination, because during this 8 weeks, 12 weeks period, they extensively go through the course material, they submit the assignments. So they are, we can say, given a lot of exposure on the course material, and they are quite confident that they'll be able to complete the course and they appear for the examination. Pass percentage has been almost 70% now. Earlier it used to be 80 to 85%, but after the implementation of 40% pass percentage, individually in the assignment and the final exam, it has taken a little dip, but I think 70% pass percentage is also very good number. On a gender basis, if you see the split of learners, it is 40 women versus 60 men. That is also good if you compare with the gender split which is available in the other academic institutions. This is very good. Consistently, this number is being followed. Now, question comes, okay, you may ask, why should I take this course for certification? Well, there was someone was asking in the question, in the forum, like, is it suitable for getting an employment or it has got any value? See, why people are taking? There are large number of people taking these courses for the credit transfer, but equally good number of learners are taking these courses for getting an internship or job opportunity. Or say, if you are in an industry, there is a need to reskill or upskill. Every after 5 years, there is a change in technology. This is a general trend. So you really need to update yourself, update your domain skill to be relevant in the industry. So many people are taking these courses primarily for updating themselves or reskilling or upskilling. That is the terminology. Additionally, many people are taking these courses for their research purposes. Okay. Or preparing for the competitive exam. Someone asked about the GATE exam. Yes, large number of students are taking these courses for preparation of GATE examination too. Now, if you see the top 20 enrollment and exam registration wise courses of Jan 2020, yes, the courses which are primarily from the computer science, say data science, AI, machine learning, certain programming languages like Python, these courses are quite popular because you have got general trend that, okay, many of the jobs are linked to this. So more and more people are taking this course, but equally good number of courses are taking courses like your enhancing soft skill and personality, soft skill development, all these courses. Okay, the reason behind is that for the job market, once you want to appear for an interview, it's not only your domain knowledge, but how do you present before the interviewer? How do you talk to your personality, your body language, your, you can say, verbal and written communication skill? All these things will matter. So there is a good demand of upskilling them or they updating them on their soft skills. So people are taking these courses for enrollment or registration also. Next comes the main challenge before NPTEL is that we find there are certain cities where you have got a large number of exam registration. Now the registration numbers are available hardly 1 month ahead of the examination. So that becomes difficult at that point to actually, say, provide you an exam center of your choice at the first choice, second choice. What the problem is that, say in Tamil Nadu, Chennai has got 48,000 registration last semester. That means, within these 3 days, we have to actually provide this many number of notes to the students for conducting the exam. And if you see the Chennai city, the number of notes that are available, that's much less. So in that scenario, it becomes difficult for us to accommodate you in your choices, the cities that you have chosen. Either we just send you to another center which is quite far off, or we have to conduct the exam on additional dates for you. So that may be clashing with some other examination dates. So this creates a problem. That is the reason we say that the major challenge before us is creating the necessary arrangement, logistic arrangement for conducting the exam. So if your college has got, say you have decided that you'll be taking it for the credit transfer, or you have got some idea like how many students from your college will be writing the exam, do intimate NPTEL beforehand so that we are prepared for that. As we said, that during the delivery of the contents, every week the faculty will be talking about the theoretical aspect and maybe little bit of problem sorting. But the problems which are in the assignment, the students have to actually understand the theory concept and solve it. So we are using the support of PMRF scholars to provide that support. In the last January 2023 session, we have actually utilized the services of PMRF scholars, 466 number PMRF scholars, and supported 284 courses, where every week they conducted live session. That means they will be physically directly interacting through the virtual media and clearing their doubts, solving the problem. These sessions are not only conducted in a live mode, but also the recorded sessions are made available so that if a student has missed it, they should be able to attend to the session later, see the recorded version. And the students who have attended this session, they say that this has been extremely beneficial. You can see different kinds of the feedback that we have received from the learners who have attended such courses. These all things you can see from the our social media handles. Now comes NPTEL stars. What are these NPTEL stars? First, let's talk about the domain scholar. Now you are saying you are in a BCA program, you want to pursue a career in a particular focused area, or you want to say take your career or pursue your higher studies in that particular area. For this, it is essential that you should have a specialized knowledge in a particular area. How do you get that knowledge? What are the courses that you should study? We are trying to give a guidance on that. We have identified certain domains and the courses that you have to complete to get an expertise in that particular domain. Okay. So we'll talk more about it in the next slide. Now, other stars are what? Other stars are that, okay, NPTEL superstars, NPTEL evangelists, motivated learners, enthusiasts, disciplined stars, and believers. What are these? Depending on your association with NPTEL, number of courses you are taking in a particular semester and your performance, or number of courses you are taking in the subsequent semester over a period of time, and your performance in the courses, we actually mark you as NPTEL star under different categories. Say if you have taken 4, 5, or 6 courses in a particular semester and you are topper in at least 3 courses, then we call you are NPTEL superstar. Then NPTEL evangelists are and motivated. NPTEL evangelist means that you are present in at least 18 examinations. 18 courses over 4 years timeline, that is 8 semesters. Within this 8 semesters, if you have taken 18 courses, registered for the exam, and you have passed in 2/3 of the courses, then you are NPTEL evangelist. NPTEL motivated learners and enthusiasts, they are similar. Only thing, if you have appeared for 8 examinations in 4 semesters, passed in 2/3 of that, one exam in each 4 semesters, you have actually consecutive semesters, you have continued in the NPTEL, then you are motivated learner, but you have completed the similar number of courses, but maybe you are not made the, you can follow the continuity. You might have done the courses, required number of courses over 4 semesters, but might have taken a break in 1 semester. In that case, you are NPTEL enthusiast. Similarly, NPTEL domain stars and believers are categorized. We'll talk more about the NPTEL domain scholars. We say in our terms that is a micro specialization. Okay, you gain an expertise in the area of interest. Okay, so naturally, once you get an expertise in a particular area, this helps you. That means once you appear for an interview, you'll be having in-depth knowledge of that particular area. If the employment is from that sector, you can really outnumber other peer group members who are appearing for the interview from your group. Okay, that feature of this is that there are, say, 6 to 7 courses with certain, say, week structure is given. You have to learn for 60 weeks, 50 weeks, 40 weeks, whatever it is, there are 6 to 7 courses that you have to complete. That comprises few core courses and elective courses. These courses have to be completed within a period of 3 years. That is, starting of the first course to the ending of the course should not cross 3 years. And in NPTEL, as you know, if you just score 40% marks, you get a certificate. But here, if you want to get a domain certificate, you should not, individual score should not fall below 55, and the average score should not fall below 60. Okay. We'll just maybe have a look at NPTEL domain page. What is there? Browse your NPTEL domain and courses. We have got 12 domains, 12 disciplines, and we have created about, you can say, 51 domains. We were seeing in the Excel sheet, the course page, there are some courses where it was written flight mechanics. So let me check here. But before we go there, we'll see what all disciplines are there. Aerospace, bioscience, biotechnology, bioengineering, chemical engineering, civil engineering, computer science, electrical engineering, faculty discipline, you have got fundamental and advanced, humanities, social science, management, mathematics, mechanical engineering, metallurgy, and materials engineering. So these are the disciplines under which different domains have been created. Say, if I just now consider, say, flight mechanics domain, you have to complete at least 50 weeks of learning. There are 4 core courses and there are 2 elective courses. That means 6 courses you have to complete and ensure that the total duration of the courses should not fall below 50. What are the core courses? These are the core courses listed. And whether this course is available for enrollment at this point? Yes. It is shown here that July to December, this course is available. So you can complete these 4 courses. You can also complete the 2 elective courses. There are a number of elective courses marked, and these elective courses can also be taken. So it should not take more than 3 or 4 semesters to complete a particular domain, if one is serious to complete a domain within this period. Okay. Then what else you have here? Our domain scholar. If you are a domain scholar, then your name and photograph will be appearing in this particular page. You can see here, it's not the domain scholars are only faculty members. You have got students, you have got employed professionals. So it's a mix of faculty, student, and you can say employed professionals from industry who are doing these courses for domain certification. Okay, you can see the domain from the employer. So this is the details. Further details I have shown from the portal. You can actually check it from nptel.ac.in/domain. This is how a sample domain certificate will look like. You'll have the certificate, your PR, your photograph, name, the domain you have created, the courses that you have completed, with the marks, QR code, all these things will be available. Now, it's not that, okay, the people are doing only one particular domain. There are a good number of people. Yes, they are doing one courses. See, 571 scholars have completed one domain, but there are 32, it's a good number. 32 scholars have completed 2 domains, and there are at least 4 people who have completed 3 domains. So this is definitely quite beneficial for the learners, because this will help you, or this will put you, give you an edge for employment opportunities. Most popular courses, if you just come to look at that from the industry perspective, yes, they are looking for the people, those who have got good expertise on the Python, data science, AI, machine learning, maybe cloud computing, Internet of Things, all these courses are most sought after courses by the industry. Then comes NPTEL initiative. We know that, okay, UGC and AICT, the 2 higher education regulators, have given the mandate that, okay, either 20% or 40% of the courses or the credits in a particular semester can be taken through from SWAYAM. While UGC has up to 40% credit from the SWAYAM, AICT has up to 20%. What is credit transfer? That means the academic council of the university or autonomous college has to approve regulation is there from the UGC and AICT, only it has to be approved by the Academic Council of the university or the autonomous institution, that saying that they are approving these courses for credit transfer. That means they have to select the course. NPTEL will say that 10-hour courses are equivalent to your one credit, 20-hour courses are equivalent to two credits, and 30-hour courses are equivalent to three credits. But again, whether they should take it as what is recommended by NPTEL, or they will enhance it by, say, two credit is made as three credit is equivalent to four credit, it's up to the prerogative of that academic council. They have to define how many credits for the course and what kind of courses they have to actually recommend for the student. From our experience, we can only suggest that it should not be recommended for the final year student, because in case they do not complete the course, it may jeopardize their schedule of internship and job opportunity. And also for the first year student, the first semester student, if possible, that should be avoided, because we understand they come from the school level. It will take some time for them to settle in the new environment. And from second semester, if they can be given certain, say, courses, 4 weeks, say, 8 week courses, say, from the soft skill or English courses, in that case, they'll just take this course. A lot of pressure will not be there. And they'll fully understand how a MOOC course actually is to be handled. What are the formalities completed? Then from third semester, you can actually give them courses which are skill-based. Okay. Otherwise, you can also do one thing, that we say that, okay, you can recommend that these are the courses you have to complete. Let the students part complete the course, then submit the course certificates for credit transfer. So that can also take place in that. We have already tied up with AICT for recognizing the NPTEL courses as faculty development program. Once you have gone to the say SWAM page, in the course page also there was a summary where under each course, it was mentioned the details, like whether it is UG, PG, when it's starting, what's the duration and all. And at the end, the red box, what is written here, highlighted here, it will be written whether it is a FDP courses or not. FDP course means if a faculty member completes this course, then he or she is eligible to get a FDP certificate. But it does not mean that these courses are only for the faculty. These courses are open for anyone who is interested to take the course. But if a faculty member completes this course and writes the exam, gets a normal NPTEL certificate, then separately they can ask for apply for the FDP certificate by paying a relevant fees. FDP certificate looks like this. It is jointly signed by the NPTEL coordinator and AICT representative. Now, if you see the recognition, we have got three variation of courses, 4, 8, and 12-week courses. So the 4-week course is equivalent to half FDP of 1 week, 8-week courses are full FDP of 1 week, and 12-week courses are equivalent to 1.5 FDP. How many courses are considered for FDP? We know that okay, last semester we offered 665 courses. Out of that, 561 courses were marked as FDP courses. Okay. Faculties, who are the people taking these courses? We find either they are student, faculty member, or impact professional. If you just see the distribution, we find there are about 5 to 7% enrollment comes from the, you can say, employed professional. About 20%, 17 to 20% numbers comes from your faculty, and the remaining people are from the student category. Okay. So this is the distribution here. Additionally, we know the single point of contact. The faculty members who are actually acting as a single point of contact for the NPTEL activities in college, they are actually the torch bearers of this NPTEL program. They are the ambassadors of this program in the institute. Now, we don't pay them anything for their effort, but they took a lot of pain. They take a lot of pain taking the inputs from the NPTEL and popularizing it, talking to the administration, motivating the students. They take a lot of activities. They participate in that and make it, say, acceptable to the administration as well as to the motivate the learners. Now, to help the students in their career perspective, excuse me. Sorry, there was some interruption. Okay, just to start with that. So what do we do for the, say, to support the SPOCs in their career path? If the SPOCs are participating in, say, in a conference, that means any of the conference, if their papers have been accepted for presentation in IITs or NITs or certain designated institutions, in that case, the faculty can be given as financial support to the extent of 25,000 to meet their requirement of, you can say, registration, travel expenses, and accommodation related expenses. So for this, what they have to do, if the SPOC's papers are accepted for presentation in any of the conferences held in certain designated institutes, they get a support of 25,000. For this, every month, the first 10 days, there is a window during which the faculty can actually apply for this, you can say, program. Faculty can actually write to NPTEL with the documents that they want an approval for getting the support. Once we scrutinize and approve it, then on completion of the internship or you can say the conference, they'll be connecting with us, giving us the document related to the expenses they have incurred, and the amount will be reimbursed to them. So for that, it is essential that you meet the conditions. That is, the institute where it is conducted is as per the NPTEL norms. Additionally, what we do? Someone was asking about the gate portal. Yes, we understand that, okay, many of the students, the learners will be interested to prepare for the gate examination, because gate exam does not only give you an opportunity for higher studies with scholarship, but also is now linked to the jobs in public sector undertaking. Okay, so there is a need to prepare better. And in gate exam, exams like gate which are conducted by IITs, you definitely know that, okay, the questions will be testing that they will be testing your in-depth knowledge of the particular subject. So you really need to understand that you should have a deeper understanding of the fundamentals. And NPTEL courses are offered by the faculty members from IITs, and many of these faculty members were associated with the preparation of the gate question paper. So they know at which extent they should be teaching the subject. So what we have done, say if you are writing the gate exam, how do we help you? First, you are from a particular discipline, you wish to get deeper understanding or different subjects that you have studied from that particular discipline. And if I, instead of going through the complete 3000 courses, if I can identify, okay, if you want to read this particular topic and get, say, deeper understanding of a particular topic, which lecture you should see. That we call syllabus mapping. So that we have done for certain courses. Yet syllabus mapping has been done for 10 disciplines. That we will be showing you later. Now you have actually taken the courses or actually connected to that particular video lecture. As for the syllabus mapping, understood the concept. Before the exam, what all other things are that we do? We try to solve previous year's question papers to get a confidence. Okay, so here also in GATE portal, what we have done? We have taken the previous year's question paper and provided you video-based solution. So you can just take the video solution. If you are not in a position to solve the problems, refer to that. next comes, before the exam, we always try to take mock examinations just to test on my timeline whether I can complete all the questions within a period of 3 hours and what is my score. So for that, we need mock test. So instead of going to a third agency, you can always take the GATE mock test through NPTEL portals. Additionally, what support you may need, so suppose you have not understood certain concept, is there anyone from NPTEL who can actually guide you in your understanding? Yes, we do offer. There are PMRF scholars who are there to provide online assistance through mentorship support. So what all things are required for your GATE preparation, all the features are available. Let me take you to the GATE portal and show you where these things are available. You just go to the GATE portal. Here, you can see all the details is here. Go to the top corner, there is a tab, say GATE syllabus mapping. We said that syllabus mapping is done. Say you are talking about, say mechanical engineering. Okay. In the mechanical engineering, if I am from mechanical engineering, what? Here, these are the subjects that I have to study. Say applied mechanics and design is the subject that I am selecting, that okay, I am studying this particular subject at this point. And under this subject, these are the topics I have got to study in depth. Say I want to have deeper understanding of the engineering mechanics. Which are the video lectures that will give me this understanding? These are the lectures by different faculty members which have been identified and mapped with the GATE portal. So if I just click on this, it will take me to a lecture which will describe, give deeper understanding of free body diagrams and equilibrium. Okay, so this is how GATE syllabus mapping has been done. Then comes what? We say that, okay, you can see the video solutions of the previous semester question papers. Say, I am from Electronics and Communication Engineering and I want to see a particular ER question paper, say EC 2022. Then these are the solutions. Okay. The question number wise, they have given the solution of the particular question. So you can also refer to the previous question paper's video solution. What else we said? We said that you can take the mock practice test. Here you can go here. Under this, you can go to the course and take the practice test. Similarly, if you want a mentoring support, that also you can engage with NPTEL and get the support from NPTEL through PMRF scholars on clearing your doubts. So in total, in a particular portal, we have tried to provide all support that are required by the student for doing well in the, say, these courses. GATE examination. Now NPTEL, I was showing in the Python course page, it was self-paced course, something was written there. What is this self-paced course? Now, so far we have talked about NPTEL, that means which are offered in a timeline during January and July. Suppose I am in industry. Okay. And I really do not have 12 weeks time to complete a course, but I really want that certificate. In that case, what I can do, can I have that flexibility that whenever I want, I should be able to take that course. It's a Python course, which was about 12 weeks duration. I want to complete it within, say, instead of 12 weeks, I want to complete it 12 days. For 15 days, I want to complete it. I have the capability. Can I do that? Yes, that is feasible. So NPTEL class or is a platform which offers that flexibility. That means I can take certain courses and complete it at my pace and time. I'll be completing the course whenever I want. Whichever duration I want, I will be able to complete that within that duration. And also, I'll be able to take the exam whenever I want. It's not a particular date in September or October. Okay, this is NPTEL Plus. Additionally, it not only offers the courses, some of the courses from NPTEL, it also offers certain courses which are skill-based training. Like it could be short-term course, long-term training programs on a particular software, on a particular, you can say, thing which are relevant in the industry. So these courses are live and blended courses. It not only contains the, you can say, regular MOOCs which are offered in NPTEL, but also short-term and long-term programs, which is can be as small as 2 to 4 weeks, 4 hours to few months also. Okay, so these are the available. What are the courses available? Can I have a look? elearn.npkl.ac.in is the portal. If I go there, what all things I'll be able to see? I'll be able to see here, see which courses available. Okay, now let me tell you, since these courses gives you a lot of flexibility in terms of when I can enroll, when I can complete, and when I can actually write the certification exam, so it comes with a cost. It's not free. The access to the contents is not free. Certain amount is charged depending on your course duration. Okay. Now, you have got variation. It can be NPTEL course, it can be IIT workshops, or it could be partnering courses. Say, if we say partnering courses, what are the courses that comes from other institutions? Say, here, the courses that are available from other institutes, you can see it here. Additionally, you can see here IIT workshops ongoing. Say this course, Getting Job Ready During College Years, it starts from 5th August. How much does it cost? Is it very costly? No. It's only 500 rupees course. They'll be charging. And I can complete it as much my convenience. So this is NPTEL class. That means these courses are offered whenever I need. These are not only offered by the faculty members from IITs, but industry professionals are also delivering these courses. Okay. So there is a basic difference between NPTEL and NPTEL class. This is already we have discussed. Then someone was asking in the beginning, internship for the toppers. Yes, we do provide internship opportunities for the learners through NPTEL. Now, it's not possible to give internship opportunity for all learners. So the topper, course toppers, are having the privilege of availing this internship. What do we do? Is there any application process? No. Then how do we select the candidates? First, once the results are out, we say that, okay, this many people are course toppers, we get in touch with the faculty. Because the internship is under the same faculty under which course, you have the topper. Okay, candidate is the topper. So we first get in touch with the faculty, get a consent from them whether he or she is available to take the internship during summer and winter. Kindly note that internships are conducted at IITs or IISc. That means this will be conducted during the vacation in IIT. Okay, so beyond, once the course starts, we usually stop the internship. The internship, we always prefer to have in person, where the student can actually go to IITs, mix with the community, the researcher community there, and get a wide exposure. Yes, some of the courses where it is not mandatory, that can be taken up as an online mode, but the preferred mode is offline. That is decided by the faculty. So the duration is 4 weeks to 12 weeks. Preferred mode is offline, where the faculty, the student has to move to that particular institution of the faculty. Okay, they have to stay in the hostel as far as possible. NPTEL is concerned, they will try to provide the accommodation in hostel if available. Otherwise, the students have to make their own arrangement. Okay, how the selection takes place. Once we get the consent of the faculty, we write back to the student that the faculty is interested for, say, 4 weeks, 8 weeks, or 12 weeks internship. If you are willing, fill up the form. They will be given a Google form, which they have to fill up. In that Google form, they have to submit 3 documents. One of the documents is the resume, latest resume. Second one is a statement of purpose. That is what they intend to do during the internship. Third is the last 2 semester grade sheet. If they say that we are in the first year, yes, you don't need to provide. But if you have the previous 2 semesters, you've studied in a college, you provide that certificate. So based on these 3 documents and your performance in the NPTEL exam, the faculty will be selecting the right number of students that can be accommodated in that particular institution. For certain courses, if there are hundreds of students, definitely all students cannot be accommodated. So some screening will be done and some students will be selected. Sometimes the faculty will be conducting an online interview, talking to the student and selecting. Okay. So that's how the selection takes place. Once they're selected, then we send them an offer letter. So no applications are required from the students. Directly, NPTEL will be directly contacting the offers for their internship opportunity. Okay. What do we provide to them in addition to the internship? To support their logistic arrangement, we provide them a token support. That is, for a 4 weeks internship, we provide them 5,000 rupees, for 8 weeks, 10,000, and 12 weeks, 15,000 rupees. This amount will be reimbursed once they complete the internship and provide the internship report. Okay. Once they complete the internship, they will be provided at the internship certificate by NPTEL as soon as we receive the details. But it may take some time to process the internship stipend and disburse it. Okay, this is the whole process. So during the period of internship, the students will be taking care of the expenditure that are required for their stay and say lodging and boarding expenses in the IITs. In addition to what NPTEL offers, we have also tied up with Texas Instruments to provide some industry internship. For this, Texas Instruments, which is leading industry in IC manufacturing, they have said that the students have to complete certain courses by, say, 4th or 6th semester. What are the courses? You can directly go to this particular portal, nptel.ac.in/ti, and get the details. But in general, they say that you have to complete the basic electrical circuits and either analog circuits or analog IC design. These courses you have to complete. Additionally, if you have completed certain other courses like your circuit analysis for analog design and introduction to time-varying electrical networks and so on, you will be given a preference. For this, the selected candidates will be undergoing an interview program under TI. And based on the interview response, the TI will be offering the internship opportunity for the selected students. Okay. Then comes soft skill training. What is this? We are offering you the course to give a deeper understanding of the knowledge of a particular course. Not only these courses are offered from the emerging areas, because we know because of the implementation of Industry 4.0, there is a lot of change in the way industry works. But again, our syllabuses are not updated in the same way. So what do? We definitely try to provide some courses aligning with the industry trend. So this will help you. But again, even if you know the subjects, you have got the required skill set, you really need to know how to write a good resume, to prepare a resume, how to take the help of social media to search for jobs. Say, your body language, your communication skill, writing skill, how to face the HR interview, what are the common questions, how to respond to that. You really need to know all these things. That there are many institutions, they actually hire certain experts from the industry and give them training. But not all students are fortunate enough, particularly from the tier 2, tier 3. They definitely lack these facilities. To help them, from NPTEL, we arrange a soft skill training to our experts. Okay. This training could be of 1 week or 2 weeks duration. For this, if your college is interested and there are 30-40 students who have taken NPTEL courses, you can actually ask our team to organize the NPTEL soft skill training for your team. Okay, we try to provide, first preference to the tier 2, tier 3 city colleges. What do we do in this period? We always try to provide you employability assessment test, English language test, online interactive sessions are done so that the experts can tell you what are your shortcomings and how do we actually overcome that. We conduct one-to-one mock test to give you a feeling of like how you should actually face the interview. All these things are part of this. So employability assessment, English language test, interactive session to tell you what are shortcomings. Then, in addition to the lectures, we also provide you certain say home tasks on a daily basis to solve those problems, it gives a comprehensive overall say inputs on your soft skill training, soft skill improvement. And that after undergoing these courses, the learners who have undergone these courses, they have actually informed their the benefit they have attained from this course, which is highly saying that about the training part. We said that we are not only connected with the colleges as the NPTEL local chapter, but also connected with the industries who are called as NPTEL industry associate. What they do? We know there are about 5 to 8% of the learners coming from the industry for the reskilling or upskilling. So there are certain industry professionals already taking these courses. So in addition to that, we have already tied up certain industries from government sector as well as from the private sector, from IT sector to all branches of, you can say, engineering, who are connected with us, not only for training their, say, employees through NPTEL, but also giving support in the course that is jointly collaborating with NPTEL and developing the courses, also providing a much needed support in the form of, say, students need certain inputs like what industry wants, leadership talks, how to develop the leadership quality. So that in addition to what they provide in terms of, say, jointly offering the course or course inputs, they are also providing talks, specialized talk, particularly catering to the needs of the learners who wants to join the industry. Additionally, you can see the spread of different industries who are connected with us as NPTEL industry associate. They're also providing the live sessions. Then, you know, in particular for the local chapters, the SPSs might be doing that. We have a program called Fee Waiver Scheme. That is, if the college feels that the certain students are really needy, but they are meritorious, but very needy, and they cannot afford to pay 1,000 rupees exam. For this, if the college checks the credential, financial credential of the students, and recommend their name for fee waiver, and if we have the funding, in that case, we try to provide 50% of the fee waiver, exam fee as waiver. Initially, the students will be registering by paying the full fee, but once they are successfully completing the course, they will be given back 50% of the fee as reimbursement. That is fee waiver. And this fee waiver comes from the industry associates, and there are a few individuals who are supporting in this initiative. More than 1.4 lakh students from different states, you can see the numbers are before you, particularly from the tier 2, tier 3 cities, have been benefited. Another program that I have shown in Python course is that in addition to the English text transcript, you have got the transcripts available in different languages, regional languages. So this is a translation effort taken by the NPTEL. More than 223 courses have been converted into different languages, but we have miles to go. This job cannot be done by NPTEL alone because we really do not have expertise on different languages. So if some of the faculty members are from local chapter colleges, are having good depth on a particular local language, as well as they know a particular, say, course details, in that case, they can engage with NPTEL and take up the job of translation activities. That means they will be given the text transcript of in English language that they have to convert to their local language. So for this, what is essential is that they should have good, you can say, background of their particular local language and good understanding of the particular subject. So if you are willing, it's a paid service, you can write back to us and support us in this initiative for the benefit of the learners, particularly from the tier 2, tier 3 cities who might have studied in their vernacular medium till class 12 standard. This translation effort is an ongoing, as we have said, you have completed 223 courses. These are the languages on which we are working. You can see not many courses, languages have been tried up. In Kannada, we could only complete 77. In Assamese, only one. Bengali, 69. Odia, we have not yet completed. So if you are having good knowledge on this particular local language, and the subject to help us in this initiative. Then we are available in different social medias like LinkedIn, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and YouTube. Whatever we do, whatever the information that we receive from the learners as part of the feedback are always published here, and we have a good follower base in all these social media platforms. The numbers only speaks about that. The NPTEL starts we talked about, we definitely encourage them and provide them a memento in the form of t-shirts so that they can proudly display that they are NPTEL stars. Lab workshops is another initiative which we usually conduct around the year, during which it's roughly about 1 week duration, during which a group of learners, 40 to 50 learners, are actually attending say laboratory workshops in a particular institution. They go to that particular institution, and during the first 5 days they will be undergoing the theoretical and experiments during morning and afternoon. And on Saturday, there will be an examination. At the end, they will be getting a certificate. For this, they have to pay a token charge of 200 rupees for attending the workshop, and the accommodation and food expenses are to be borne by the candidates themselves. Okay. Now, this is local chapter. To become a local chapter, NPTEL local chapter, I understand today's organizer, one of the college which is participating with us is a local chapter, but if you consider that is for the general information, then to become a local chapter, you really don't need a building, separate room and all. Only the interest to become a local chapter is what is required. If you are interested, there is a form. You can go to the nptel.ac.in and download the form from there. You can see there, join as local chapter. A particular form is available, the booklet about NPTEL, what is NPTEL, all these informations are available. Fill up the form, submit the documents, and within a 7 or 10 days time, we approve the local chapter. And once we, you become a local chapter, then you can say that a dedicated page app for local chapter is created under NPTEL. Say, if you just say here, this is how a local chapter page looks like. It will bear the name of the college, the SPOC details, and if this college, the students from this college are actually enrolling in NPTEL courses, their numbers, all the details, if they are topper, all these details, like there are 8 toppers, all these details will be available under this tab. Okay. What are the benefits of this? Once you become a local chapter, the benefits is that you get all your information under your local chapter page. Then whoever is enrolling into the course enrolled status, exam registration status, assignment data, all these are available to the SPOC through the dashboard. They can apply for the fee waiver, what we called about the needy students fee waiver. That has to come from the local chapter. So they can apply for the fee waiver. They can actually allocate the mentors for the needy students. Local request for the local exam center, if it is, say, if the college is located in a far off place, but there is no local examination center at a nearby place, they can request for the local exam center, provided certain number of students are writing the exam. Additionally, if they are interested, they can actually send, they can say, the hard disk and get the content, say 60,000 hours of content, copy it in their hard disk free of cost and put it into the local repository, so that for read-on courses, the students can actually use these contents as a library resource material whenever they want. So these are the benefits associated. We are currently working with about more than 5,500 local chapters spread across different countries, different states. Okay. And based on the performance of the students from these local chapters are rated. First, as active local chapter, that means if there are at least 25 students writing the exam from a particular college and at least 50% of them successfully complete the course, then it is active local chapter. Okay. Then comes, based on the performance, we calculate certain points, and if the college is within top 100, based on the points, we rate the colleges as AAA, AA, or A. As we understand, the college with whom we are working today, they are within the top 100 local chapter colleges, as it was pointed out by the principal, sir. We are also having local chapters outside India, because there are many students are now writing the taking the courses from outside India and also writing the exam in a proctored manner. Local chapter participation has been continuously good, and currently almost 90% exam history enrollment comes primarily from the local chapters. This we have already talked about, that you can see that maximum registration comes from few of the local states, like 21% registration comes from 555 local chapters in Tamil Nadu. Yes, many of the colleges have become local chapter, but they are not active in that sense. That means there not even 25 candidates are writing the examination in a semester. They become the local chapters, but they are not taking the courses or encouraging their students to take the courses. Now, the suggestion for the local chapter is that initially you can always encourage soft skill or English language courses, then you can go for the programming or skill-based courses like data science, Internet of Things, machine learning, etc. Then you can actually encourage the students, particularly for taking the domain courses, so that they can complete it within, say, 3 or 4 semesters, a particular domain. They can explore the GATE portal, because it has got a consolidated overview of what all things are required to prepare better for the GATE examination. Initially, they can think of taking all rerun courses, because they have complete idea about what's the video. They can prepare much beforehand based on the one set of assignment available. Although the new set of assignments will be different, but they will have some idea about the type of or the quality of assignment questions. Okay. If your college is actually encouraging the students for taking the NPTEL courses, it's good that if you can actually mark a slot in your timetable for the NPTEL courses, there is a faculty who is acting as a mentor come during the and interact with the students during that allotted time. Okay, and ensure that there is no college activity around the NPTEL exam days. Mentors are also given recognition if the mentees are doing well. So based on the performance of the mentees, certain points are allocated for each performance rating, like if they are successfully completing elite, elite gold, elite silver and all. And if the mentors get at least 10 mentorship points, they are given a mentorship certificate. With this, I'll close the session here. We have already crossed the timeline. If there are any questions, we'll take up the questions. Otherwise, I'm handing over the stage to the SPOC for the taking over. Whatever questions were coming in the YouTube chat box, we have responded. Since there is no other questions, maybe the SPOC can take over. Over to SPOC. If someone is having any doubt about this, kindly post your queries in the chat box so that we can respond to it. There is a question that if the students have completed the assignment but could not write the exam, then if they cannot write the exam, then naturally they have to go for the next semester. There is nothing like that. Okay. We can take the exam separately for them. If they want to write the exam the next semester, now we are permitting that they can actually take the assignment score from here and take it for the next semester. But it's always good that if the students can actually take a next set of assignments and prepare accordingly.
Over to you. Any questions that to be posted?
There There is okay. no question Google. Sorry, YouTube. There is no question. Whatever questions came, we try to answer to that.
Then we definitely had from 2019. We were a part of NPTEL, and almost 8 batches have completed from Soundarya Institute of Management and Science. And as sir was telling about, our journey in NPTEL was really good because 4 consecutive year we were having in the top 100 colleges who have done it. But as you all know that engineering colleges have this as a mandatory, but we the degree colleges, it's an optional. But however, the few departments like computer science department, the management department, commerce department, so there were a lot of courses that have been taken, including the international language, German, French. So all these were taken by the students and they have cleared it. And the best part was many of the teachers from these institutions are also willing and they have done a lot of courses. And we were, in the very first batch, one of our faculty member also had scored the rank he was in the top 2. In the 2%. Entire examination on corporate, costing management, I think. So he was the one who has completed, and he was been also invited in IIT during 2019-20. And 4 times I was the SPOC, I got a best mentoring award for the completion, successful completion of almost 70-80% of the students have cleared the exam. That's one great thing that the institution has in its history. And coming to that, sir, this year, we are really, having a plan to have more domain certification rather than 1 or 2 certificates so that we can keep track of the students in one part. I truly agree and believe the program structure has been designed on a domain certifications. So on this regard, I know it was a real informative that which how we can start with. So that's how it's a future plan. And one small concern that I would like to mention through this platform is it so happens there are internship programs and other things that we been offered to mechanical engineering, chemical engineering, and mechatronics and other things. R is like it's not such an allied department. We have more on engineering, concept. We have more on theoretical and practical. I do agree. But there was a little less chances for a degree students to get into more on internship programs, more on the hands-on training program in IIT. So if there is some general boot camps programs for everyone who all can opt, so I would be much obliged that if you have some boot camps, learning the same concept in my institution is very much different from learning the same concept in IITs because the ecosystem, the feel of learning also matters. So what I would request is if there is a future plan of having some boot camps for the students, probably around 3 days or 2 days with a stay. So that really impacts, the learning environment. So that's only one request that I have from my end. And it was really informative, sir. The session was, it was a complete walkthrough from the point A to point B. So it was really amazing. And thank you for your valuable time. And I must thank IIT Madras because whenever I approach Kamala ma'am or whenever I approach Bharti ma'am, every time there was a supporting system that was lent to our college. So thank you so much. And
actually,
now I
at this point, maybe interrupt you one.
Yes, sir.
You can explore. Yes, there is a program called Microsoft Future Ready Talent, the FATI program. Yourself or some of the faculty members can explore that program. And the students who are doing well in the courses, they are given that privilege that there is certain awards of program that needs to be completed in the Microsoft FATI program. They get a lot of exposure on that. Is a future ready talent.
So is this program under SWAYAM itself?
No, it's not under SWAYAM. It's directly between NPTEL and Microsoft. There's a new initiative. You can just type out NPTEL future ready NPTEL Microsoft Future Ready Talent Program, and you'll get further details about. Sorry, because of the constraint of time, there are many things that really cannot be touched upon, because the NPTEL is not only taking, just offering the courses. There are many, many new initiatives are taken for the benefit of the learners, so that they are better job ready. It's a Microsoft Future Ready Talent effort.
Okay. So definitely, sir, I think this would really help us both, because this is a time where not only the students, even the faculty members has to be, you know, upskill by self. They have to level themselves, because it's very competitive for both of us. And being an NEP introduction, that itself is a challenging, and, you know, making this students to level up as required by the institution and other organization. Anyway, sir, thank you so much. And I request now Rupa ma'am to take over for the whole talk.
I think there is a question from, two questions from the learners. Before we close the session, just in the light of semester pattern, especially with NEP, how to conduct or select students? How to conduct or select students? This is asked by Uttara Singh. Selecting students, I would only say, see, that we are offering, say, 690 courses, but all courses, although we say that you can start, anyone can join in any of the courses, but some of the courses, after the results are declared, we find that, okay, some courses which are prescribed for a particular group of students, they're not really suitable for them. Okay, and say if there are about 1,500 students taken the course, hardly even 5% students have not cleared. The reason behind is that that particular course possibly had required a deeper understanding of mathematical background, and that was not taken into account while prescribing the course for the students. Because if the student's background does not match with the course background that is required, it will be difficult. So what we can do, what we can suggest is that initially, instead of just prescribing one or two courses, you can possibly request them to take maybe three or four courses, enroll into that, take 2 or 3 weeks, then decide on which course to continue. In some of the courses, we have seen that the students have, or after interacting with the college SPOCs and the administrators, they said the students could follow up to, say, second week, third week. Beyond that, they could not follow. In that case, after third week, there is no option to switch from one course to another course. So in that case, the other option is that you allow the students to enroll in multiple courses. Okay. Then let the students complete 3 or 4 weeks. If they feel that certain courses cannot be completed because it's becoming tough for them, they can drop from that course and continue with the other course. This decision has to be taken by the faculty. This is first part. Then there is some question from Banerjee. Sir, please let us know if there are benefits to the students who give exam. Yes, as we said that, see, one thing you have to consider, that once a prospective employer comes, and they are going to interview 60 students. If you consider the base merit of, raw merit of all the students are equal, they are referring the same book sets, they are being guided by the same faculty. Then once the employer comes, whom they should choose? Because everyone knows the same thing. Someone has to put them in a different bracket. And if they do certain courses which are aligned with the industrial trend current, the latest trend, which is not mandated by the college for getting a degree, then definitely he or she is getting noticed. Not only that, so this gives them a lot of advantage in getting the employment. Another thing is that once they join an industry, if you just go through any other FICCI, NASCOM, or any other report, they say the industrial scenario is changing every after 5th year. There is a general trend. Because of the implementation of Industry 4.0, things are changing very rapidly. Every second day, newer technologies are coming. So even if they are joining in, say, IT sector, today they are working in a particular project, they have got expertise on a particular programming language. Tomorrow, suddenly, they change their, say, project from one project, they are going to another project. In that case, they will be required to learn a newer programming language. Now, in a college atmosphere, the teachers are there to support them in their learning initiative. But what happens once they go to the industry? They have to learn it themselves. There will not be anyone. So this is the time when they should be encouraged for self-learning. They should be encouraged. They should know how to learn themselves. So it's not only helps them to get a job at this point of time, but also prepares them how to learn. If they know how to learn themselves, then tomorrow, once they are in industry, they will be able to retain their competitiveness in the job market. That's what I can only say. Okay, thank you. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you so much, sir. Hopefully, I'm audible.
Yes, yes.
Good afternoon, all. Today marks the conclusion of a remarkable event, and I stand here with a heart full of gratitude to express our deepest thanks to all who have contributed to this success. First and foremost, I extend my heartfelt appreciation to our distinguished guest, speaker, resource person. His valuable insight, expertise, and active engagement has been the driving force behind the success of this event. Thank you, sir. Next, I would like to thank our management, Manjappa Soundarya, Chairman, Sunita Manjappa, MD, Kirtan Kumar Manjappa, CEO, Pratiksha Kirtan Manjappa, Managing Trustee, and Varun Kumar Manjappa, Managing Trustee. In their absence, I would like to thank their support and guidance that they have provided to us. Next, I would like to express my sincere thanks to our organizing committee, especially Rekha ma'am, and all the volunteers who have worked tirelessly behind the scenes. Thank you, ma'am, and all the volunteers here. A special words of thanks goes out to our beloved SIMS faculty members, our beloved students, and who has directly and indirectly supported to the platform of learning and sharing and also networking here. Once again, on behalf of SIMS, I thank each one of you. Thank you, sir, and thanks all. I think we can end up the session. Over to Rekha ma'am.
Jayashree.
Okay. So with your permission, can we end the session?
Yes, yes. Jayashree, I'm requesting the NPTEL team just to close the session. NPTEL
okay.
Can kindly...
Anyways, thank you one and all again. Yes, sir. Yes, sir, please go ahead, sir.
No, I'm requesting NPTEL team to stop live streaming and end the session.
Sir, I think we can wind the session. Okay, students, thank you so much. And let's wind up the session. You can all log out. Okay, thank you once again, sir. We will wind the session. We'll leave the session.
Yes.